Hello and welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. I am Shivam Vijay. Today in this video, I am going to give a demo of embedded trainer. The order code for this embedded trainer is 43543. Basically, this trainer based on PIC controller of 18F series. We are now going to see the description of the board and then we follow the description by practicals. So this is our complete setup board of PIC18F embedded trainer. The order code for this trainer is 43543. You can use this order code to find out the specification and to check the other accessories and other details about the product by visiting our website, which is www.tescaglobal.com. This is the computer to USB cable by which the trainer can be connected with the PC for programming. And this is the spare 9-pin D-type cable for DB9 connector for communication of serial, and this is the case by which you can easily cover the kit to prevent from dust and other hazardous equipments. And this is the motherboard over here on the main board, and these are the other electronics components on devices that will be explained one by one in this video. So for other hardware description, we will start with the CPU, which is the microchip CPU of 18F452 operating at 4 MHz speed. On chip, 32 KB flash memory and 1536 byte RAM is provided. On chip, 256 EEP ROM also provided, and this is the on chip UART, SPI, I2C and PWM developing board. On chip 8 channel 10 bit ADC to DAC also provided, and on chip 32 IO lines are provided with 14 pin connector. So this is the IO lines with 40 pin connector is also provided. The complete setup can be facilitated by ISP programming, which is optional, but we will program the complete setup with this. Onboard reset key also provided. This is the onboard reset key here, and onboard applications like 16 LED or 18 LED digital output indicators, 8 LEDs digital input switches to provide the digital input, 16x2 alphanumeric LCD backlight with backlight display, and 12 volt SPT relay and 4 digit 7 segment display to see the working of 7 segment with the PIC controller, and I2C compatible with 24C515 EP ROM and DS1307 RTC suitable with the battery inside, and also temperature sensor LM35 here to provide the temperature value in the digital form, and temperature sensor for interfacing using DS18B20 IC provided here. 24 IO lines provided on a 26 FRC connector to connect the external interface. Also, we have onboard supply of plus minus 12 volt, 5 volt, 3.3 volt and 2 volt is provided. The complete setup works on the 220 volt AC power supply. All ICs are mounted in IC sockets, bare board tested with glass epoxy, SMOBC PCB is used. The complete structure is devised, and this is the USB connector to connect the USB by PC, and these are the AI ADC input output terminals at which you can check the analog inputs and outputs for the complete setup. Now we are going to communicate this complete setup by turning on this, and then we communicate and software description will be also explained. So this is the complete user manual in which all the details about the kit are given, and this is the blog description. Here you can read out all the various equipments and electronic components that are mounted on the PCB, and complete setup or the complete details about all the ICs and different timer pulses and other modules are given in this user manual. You can study the complete PIC18F embedded trainer. All the details are given in this user manual. Also, this is the hardware description of all the pins and different ICs provided on the panel. The connection and the PIC connection are also provided in this. After that, we have the sample programming For this, the codes are already generated and created to explain and to verify the kit, how the kit works with the PIC controller, and the embedded programming is also. And this is the ISP software for downloading the already generated code from us to the complete setup. Now we are going to use the already generated codes to provide the programming with this PIC ISP programmer. The complete description of how to install the PIC kit software to the computer is given in this section, and you can use this PIC2 programmer to programming the microchip PIC18F. So now we are going to program the PIC18F, and then we see how the PIC18F will work with the devices provided on the onboard. Now for starting the kit, we will first connect the 220 volt AC power supply to the connector provided on the upside of this kit. Then you can turn on the trainer kit by on off switch. The trainer kit is on, the LCD is showing that. Now use the USB to PC cable on the USB connector. So connect this USB to this USB connector. Make sure the USB switch, ISP programming switch, is in on condition. This is the on off switch here to on off the programming, and this should be connected in the PC. So we have connected other end of this PC cable to the PC USB slot, and the programming switch is in on condition. So it is displaying us, this is the USB here. So USB LED is blinking, or the on for the continuous. And now we are going to communicate this kit by using the programming software PIC kit 2 on the computer. So we are going to use PIC kit 2. This is the programming ISP software for this. When you on this software, you will find information which is PIC kit 2 found and connected. So that we have connected the PIC with the cable. So this is detected the PIC 18. Now we have to first select the device family, which is PIC 18F for this section. Now select part with this device drop down menu, in which you have to select the PIC 18F4520 for this. So we are using the same IC here in the motherboard. Now we will connect the IC and import the already connected or designed program for this in this code. So this software and the complete folders will be provided with the software's CD, in which this is the pack PIC18F4520. In this, the code folder should be opened, and now we will start programming this with the dip switch program, let us say. In this, you have to go inside the DIST folder for hex programming, because we are using ISP programmer here. Now open default folder, then production, and this is the hex file you will get here. So hex file successfully imported here. This is showing at this message, and the hex codes are also changes, because in the last there is no hex file, so the all memory locations are blanked, which is showing FF for the reference. Now our hex file is now imported. Now we will download this to the controller. Now for writing the memory of PIC18F in the controller board, make sure you have connected the controller board with this, and now press write on this programming section. As you press write, the program verifying and programming the memory, and after that you will get the programming successful message here. And now we will go to trainer board, and you will see on the LCD display that the programming is done, And when you press this reset button on the motherboard, this is start reading 8-bit DIP switches. Now there is no output on the display because we have to on the selector switches for 8 input switches here. So on the switch SW1 we have to on the switch number DIP switch number 4, and also we have to on the 1, 2, 3 for the LED display. So this is the DIP switch here, which is switch number 1, and you have to on the DIP switch 1, 2, 3 for LCD open and DIP switch number 4. So I have on the all DIP switches here for the required configuration. Now we will see this is the 0 at all the inputs in the hex, and now this is the input logic level input switches DIP or the input logic switches, all are in the off condition. Now as I on the switch, you will get the display output on the LCD screen as well. You can see as I on the first input, LED is glowing input status, and also it is showing at the LCD screen. Similarly, I will on the other input 1, and the hex value is showing in the lower line, which is 3. Similarly, this is 7 in the binary to decimal, or the hex value for all the ones are F, which is showing it this. So I will on all the inputs and we will see the value is FF for when on the inputs are on. So you can try out different combinations to see the hex value or the input binary value on combination. So this is the binary value in the upper line and the hex value in the lower line, you can see. So this is how you can use the LED input switches with the PIC18F programming section. Now for other sample program, now we are going to use the 7 segment program. For this we have to switch on the 5, 6 and 7 DIP switch on the switch 1, have to off the 1, 2, 3 and 4 and 8 for DIP switch 1. DIP switch 2 should be off, DIP switch 3 should be off, and regarding all the jumpers and switches information given in this table. Now as described in this, we have to on the DIP switch 5, 6 and 7. So DIP switch 5, 6 and 7 is on. You can see power is provided to the LED 7 segment LED, and DIP switch 1, 2, 3 and 4 are in off condition as described in this program, and press reset once. Now we will download the program for 7 segment LED or the codes which are already written in the hex language. So we are going to PC now and import the hex file. For this, in the course you have to find the folder 7 segment provided in this. Here you can see this is the 7 segment folder. Now open this, again go to DIST folder, then default production, and this is the 7 segment production hex file. So this hex file is important now in the ISP programmer, and when you press write, the hex file is designed to display the good in the 7 segment 4 digit 7 segment LED display. So we write the program to the memory. After successful programming, we are getting the display which is good on the 7 segment LED. So this is how we program the 7 segment LED for this program. Similarly, now we can follow the temperature and other RTC program also given in the user manual. Now for RTC, the real time clock program, we have to follow the DIP switches for turning on the LCD display. So 1, 2 and 3 will be on, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8 should be in off condition. So now we are turning on the LCD display switches, which is 1, 2 and 3 in the on condition, and remaining switches should be in off conditions. So we will turn off the LCD, sorry, 7 segment LED display that I have turned off. So display is now turned off, LED 7 segment. Now we will import the program of RTC. The RTC IC is already installed on the main board, and we now going to select the RTC here, I2DS1307 RTC clock program. So we will open this folder, then dist and production. Here this is the hex file, this should be imported, and now write to the device memory. The programming is successful, and RTC clock is showing right now. So this is saying that acknowledge one. So we have to open the switches 3 and 4 on the switch 2 here on the dip switch for I2C programming from the memory. So we on this 3 and 4 switch and press reset. So real time clock is now showing. Override the real time and setting new date and time. Done. And reading RTC time through the IC, which is 2359 sec hours, time, minutes and seconds in continuation is showing. So this is showing the RTC of exact that at where the program has been built. So time will be starting from the time taken at where the program is built. So program has been built on 31st 12 2019, and this is now continuously turning the real time clock on. Now we are going to see the LM35 temperature sensor, how this works with the PIC controller. For this, the 8 number program already code is derived, so we can use this code to programming the PIC controller. So LM35 temperature controller, for this we have to on the 1, 2 and 3 dip switches on switch 1, 4, 5, 6 and 7, 8 on off condition and other are in off condition. And for switch I2C is 3 and 4 should be on, and 1 and 2 switch should be on. So jumper position are also provided. We have to select the jumper position. For jumper 5 is at 2 and 3 pin, and jumper 6 should be 1 and 2 pin. So on the board you will see there are two jumpers. This is jumper 6 here and this is jumper 5. So jumper 6 should be at 1 and 2 position. So we will turn this jumper pin by pulling up this and put this on 1 and 2 position carefully. Make sure you do not damage the pin. And jumper 5 should be at 2 and 3 position, which is already at 2 and 3 position. Now we write the program for temperature LM35. So we have to find out the program from the codes. For importing X, now this is I2C LM35 program in the codes. Again go to dist folder, default, production, and this is the hex file. This is import to the ISP programmer, and then we write this. The program has been successfully writing, and on the display you can see LM35 voltage reference and different values. You can again start the display, initial display, ADC DAC LM35 channel 1 voltage and current temperature of the room is right now in degree Celsius showing at this LCD display, which is 23. Now, as I touch the LM35 sensor with my hand, the temperature will start increasing and it will getting the temperature of my hand, which is 27. And when you put any hot object near about the LM35 sensor, you will get the temperature of this hot sensor or any other thing on the display in degree Celsius. So this is how LM35 sensor is working for this, with this PIC controller. Here you can see temperature 28, increasing 29 in other case. So you can put any of the hot object around this sensor. Do not touch the hot object, so the sensor will be damaged. So make sure to make a proper distance from the sensor, and the temperature heating will be observed by the sensor, and this will give you the temperature value on the LCD screen. Now we will see the analog to digital conversion and digital to analog conversion on the PIC controller with the program code already written in the codes. For this we have to turn on the dip switch 1, 2 and 3 at switch 1, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8 should be off, and other switches and conditions are provided. For I2C, this is the also I2C programming, so we have to on the 3 and 4 switch on the switch 2, and jumper position should be taken care at jumper 5 should be at 2 and 3 position, and jumper 6 should also be at 2 and 3 position for connecting the analog input 1 to the conditions. Now we will going to write up the program on the PC. So we have to see the ADC file. For this, go to folder code, then search I2C ADC DAC folder here, then select dist, then default production, and this is the hex file that we have to upload to the IC. Now press write, the hex file and hex program will be uploaded to the IC on the motherboard. Now we are going to LCD display. Here as you write up the program, the LCD display will start. So we will reset this again, so you can see the starting display. You can observe the ramp output at AOUT terminal with using a CRO or DSO. This will be a very low frequency output, and these are the all AI inputs terminal value. This is continuously shuffling because there is no input provided and any value. So now we are going to provide 5 volts to all the inputs one by one, then we see the 5 volts value in the hex or in the digital form which is 255 will be displayed at all the AI ports. So I'm using the onboard 5 volt supply for this. So connecting the patch cord here on the 5 volt terminal, the ground is internally connected, so we just have to touch the other end of this patch cord to these AI terminals. This is AI 1, 2, 3 and 4. This is ground and this is AOUT terminal for this section. This is CN610 here connector. Now as I touch the terminal to AI1, you can see the value of AI1, 5 volts is provided to this terminal, and the value is 255 and continuously hold because the continuous value is provided on this terminal. Similarly, as I touch the terminal to AI2, the value is again 255 for this terminal, you can see here. And now for terminal 3, the 5 volts display in digital is 255 on AI3. Similarly for AI4, the 255 5 volt display in continuous holding position or the digital position for this is digital output, which is analog output converted in digital is 255 at AI4. So this is how we program the PIC controller in different modes. So that's how we program the PIC18F series IC, which is on the daughter board with this trainer with the embedded setup, and for different devices like sensors of temperature, 7-segment LED display and LCD display, or input output switches are given. So all the sample programs codes will be provided with the trainer kit, and you can study. Also, you can build up your own compilation with the compiling software, which is also provided with this trainer kit. The installation information and other supports will be provided with this kit, and you can use to develop your own program accordingly to the sensor, which are also provided on the trainer board. So you can use the sensors like RTC and other temperature sensors which are provided with this. So you can do other experiments with this also by practicing on this kit by your own. So this is how I give the brief description about the trainer and how to program the software with the ISP programming software on this trainer board. And while working with this kit, you can use the user manual with this, so that you can get the details about other descriptions in the hardwares and other software modules. And also, if you find any difficulties while working with this kit, you can contact Tesca Technologies Private Limited for all types of supports. Thank you.